Hi, this is Rob. I'm going to review and show how to create a hyperlapse video with the Sony A6000 compact mirrorless camera and Microsoft Hyperlapse Pro software. On May 14, 2015, Microsoft published Microsoft Hyperlapse Pro software that creates stabilized on-the-move time lapses, also known as hyperlapses. I'm going to review how well Hyperlapse Pro works with Sony A6000 video. Let's get started. I'm using the Sony A6000 camera. It will set the camera to produce MP4 video. Go to the menu here, hit enter, and select MP4. Now shoot some moving video. I'm in my father-in-law's car shooting video with the A6000 on a mini tripod called the UltraPod 2. The video ended up being about 9 minutes long, and I will convert that 9 minute long video into a 30 second hyperlapse video using Microsoft Hyperlapse Pro software. Now let's download the Hyperlapse Pro software. Go to research.microsoft.com and look for Hyperlapse and click on Hyperlapse. Eventually you want to get to this download page here. I'll put a link below in the description. Hyperlapse Pro is free and you need at least a 64-bit version of Windows 7. I am using Windows 7 64-bit. Click the download button. It took me about 9 minutes to download the software. Once it is finished downloading, click open. This window pops up. Click Run. Now I get this unexpected window that states that Hyperlapse Pro needs some C++ libraries, and if I want to obtain these libraries from the web. I'm reluctant, but I go ahead and click Yes. It takes me to this download page. I read the system requirements and click Download. Then it takes me to this page and asks me to choose the download that I want. It gives me a choice of 3 executable files. I don't have a clue, so I choose all 3 and click Next. Then I click Run. This window pops up. I agree to the terms and click Install. Now that those libraries are installed, I go back to my downloads file and double-click on the Hyperlapse software to install it. It takes about 10 minutes to install, and when it is ready, here's what it looks like. Let's load up the A6000 video. At the top, click New. Create a new project. Go to where the A6000 file is located and open it. The video is now loaded in the Hyperlapse software. We need to choose a start point for the video. This bottom slider allows you to quickly go through the video. The top left slider is used to select the start point for the Hyperlapse. I want my Hyperlapse to start here. Now go to the top right slider to choose an endpoint for the Hyperlapse. I'll choose this spot as my ending point in the Hyperlapse. Now at the top, click the Next button. This takes us to Settings, the sidebar to the right. The first option is choose the camera model. The only camera models to choose from are the GoPro models and 2 Sony action cameras at the bottom. The Sony HDR AS100VR and the Sony HDR AZ1. So this Hyperlapse software is geared towards action cameras. Microsoft may add other action cameras to the list, but I doubt they will add the Sony A6000. So I'm going to choose Unknown Camera. Shoot mode is NA. Next is Speed Control. This is where you can choose how fast you want your Hyperlapse to be. You can choose a speed factor up to 25x. As you move the speed factor slider, you can see on the bottom what the estimated time of the final video will be. In this case, a speed factor of 20x will turn my 9-minute video into a 30-second hyperlapse. If I increase that to 25x, it will give me a 24-second hyperlapse video. Next is smoothing. The two choices is Standard and Advanced. Advanced is only available if your camera model is on the list above and you selected your camera model. I choose Unknown Camera, thus the Advanced Smoothing option is not available. Next, Output. You can choose where you want the finished Hyperlapse video to be saved. Resolution. You have 3 choices, 1080, 720, and 540. I'll choose 720. Frame Rate. I'll choose 30 frames per second. Now click Next to start processing the Hyperlapse. It took 12 minutes to process this 9-minute video into a Hyperlapse. Before I show you the final hyperlapse, I noticed a big problem. The video on the left is the original video from the Sony A6000 camera. The video on the right is the hyperlapse. Microsoft Hyperlapse Pro cropped the bottom of my video. You see the original on the left? You can see the hood of the car. The hyperlapse video on the right has cropped the bottom off, thus making my video appear to be looking more up to the sky. I thought this might be due to my choosing 720 format when the video was recorded at 1080. So I re-ran the software to produce a 1080 hyperlapse, and the result was still a cropped video. This may be due to the fact that the Sony A6000 is not one of the supported camera models. Another thing I don't like about this hyperlapse is that Microsoft places a watermark on the lower right of the video. This is supposed to be a pro version of the software. Usually when the software has pro in the title, there's no watermarks in the final product. I know that this software was free, but don't call it pro if you're going to put your watermark on it. Also at the end of the hyperlapse, Microsoft puts this black display ad at the end of the hyperlapse. I don't think I'll be using Microsoft Hyperlapse Pro unless I have one of the supported action cameras. If you like this review, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel.